Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today, I've had so many calls this week on noise that I think probably 30. So I put this video together as a result of all the calls I've had this week because I start to see a common thread, okay? And the thread is, I got to build something. I want to build something. I have to build something. And it seems like the desire or the drive to build supersedes what you need to build to solve the problem. They know a problem exists, but they don't know exactly what to build. They read about this, that, or the other, and they just want to build something. I don't understand it, but I see it permeating through all the calls, almost all calls on noise. They know there's a problem. They know they have to build something. They don't really know quite what to build, but they know they got to build something. And to build something overrides what they're supposed to build. I don't get it. I don't understand it. Is it excitement? Is it the desire to get in the shop and build something? I don't know, but it's wrong. It's just wrong from so many angles that I don't even have time to go into all of them. So let's back up a little bit and work with the good things that we have and go from there. So we're not running to stand still, really, because that's what's going to happen. Guessing with noise is a fool's game. You will guess wrong 95 to 98% of the time, and you will fail. And here's the problem with failure. It's not easily fixed, because noise is a permanent construction fixed. 80% of the fixes we have to tell people result in demolition. And believe me, nobody wants to hear that. But that's the truth. The barrier is a structure that you place between the source and the receiver. Barrier materials and construction are frequency and amplitude dependent. Just that one variable there should turn the light bulb on. If you don't know what to build, but you do know that all the materials are frequency and amplitude dependent, then all you got to do is find out the frequency and the amplitude of the problem. Measurement. But nobody does that. You want to guess? They want to describe it. Oh, it's garbage truck noise. It's road noise. It's guy with stereo next door noise. It's foot traffic noise. It's this. It's that. Here's the problem with those kind of literal transcriptions. They don't describe the problem because the problem is frequency and amplitude. So you have to have that. You have to measure for that. Noise transmission is vibrational acoustics. We're taking a big airborne energy wave, striking a structure, and trying to come out on the end like this. What happened to go from this to this? This. It has to be designed to do this. And you got to know what the problem is. You got to know the frequency and the amplitude of source in order to build this barrier. We're dealing with vibrations. So what we're trying to do is go from a snake to a worm. That's what we're trying to do. So we want to make sure that we have a proper design that allows for that. Let me give you a little example. If you're dealing with noise below 125 hertz, the first layer of your barrier has to have three times the density as anything else inside of it. So how do you know what material to use just on the outside that faces the source? You don't, without measurement. And this is why all the time people are running to stand still, because they don't know what they're running towards. because they haven't measured. You got to measure noise. We have a process. Most people don't fail, or they want to fail, build to fail. They just fail to plan. So you got to measure. Okay, we have a process. We send you apps, download them on your phone. I've tried to make this as painless as possible and not introduce any more error into the equation that's already there in human minds. Download the apps, take the measurements per our instructions. Please follow our instructions. Don't interject anything of your own. We've done over 2,000 of these. Believe me, I have the process figured out. I know more than you do. So just follow the process. Fill out the information on an online data sheet and send it back to us. I'll analyze it against our database. I'll look at the noise pressure map you took for over 7 days. I'll analyze all that for you, and I'll send you a drawing so you can build that. So take the energy that you want to do in building and transfer it to measuring. Got to have it over 7 days, because some days are louder than others, and I got to know what's going on. We're going to make assumption that that 7 days is representative of the whole month. I hope. If it's not, you have to let us know, because we're after the peak week, the peak day, or whatever it is. So noise is complicated. Don't be running to stand still, because you're going to spend all that time building something you think is going to work, and it won't. 95 to 98% of the time. Don't do that to yourself. Life's too short. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.